Up. You're very close, I know. You guys don't need to see my pores. First off, I want to start the video saying hi. Second thing, unplug the stupid thing. Today we're going to go through a back day, pull day, and I posted a video 2 days ago. It's a pretty video. I don't recommend watching it, but I highlighted in that video that I'm doing the Build Man program, which is a Shredded for Life program. All the cool kids are doing it. And it's legs push pull, legs push pull. So leg muscles are what? Yes, they're leg muscles. Push is your chest, shoulders, and these guys that are not big enough on myself, triceps. And then we have pull, which is yes. Pull is your back and your biceps, stuff like that. You see that?
Yeah.
Look. That right there. Right here.
Okay.
Shoulder blades are back. And now, from that point, I initiate the lift. We don't want to be, because if I don't do that, it looks like this.
It's kind of two movements.
It is. Back. Those are also called scap ups. Like if you were gonna do pull ups. And then shout out to Mr. Brendan Myers for this. But
shout out Brendan.
If I'm hanging and I'm just going like this, what am I doing? Retracting the scapula, shoulder blades back.
Oh yeah.
And this disengages the shoulders, front shoulders that like to get involved. And it turns on. When you do this, you actually feel your lats turn on. You feel the engagement and you're able to isolate those. And then from that position, drive the elbows down. Shorten those lats.
Looks like... Oh, God. What the hell is that, Bob? What the hell are you doing?
You look like an idiot.
Good form. No joke. This isn't a game.
Let's go, bro. So, I gotta say this. Before I lift off, I'm engaging my glutes and my hamstrings as if I'm gonna do a deadlift. Weight on the midfoot slash your heel, essentially avoiding the front of your toe. We want to feel stable when we're doing these rows. We're being pulled forward. Try to have your chest come over the bar a bit more. And also a wider grip. Have your pinkies right inside this nail here. So like right there. All right, so chest up. Barbell row. I was talking to Hayden about we want to set our feet first. We want to make sure our weight is on the middle of our foot slash our heel. We want to have a firm base with all free weight movements, assuming that we aren't like laying down on a bench or something like this. So it's pretty easy to remember, right? So before you're initiating a set, feet up is the thought. Set my feet in a proper position. Then from there, we can place our hands on the bar, be intentional about that. I notice with both of them at times they'll forget to really, really pay attention about the grip that they have on the bar before they would initiate a set. This is something I learned the hard way, again, being a beginner, but making sure that we are in, our hands are evenly distributed and in the same spot on either side of the bar. So bars often have knurling, and you can, which are, knurling is very helpful to indicate, you know, are we gonna be balanced with this weight when we're performing a set? And they'll be a couple inches off before initiating a set. I remember reminding Hayden of this yesterday. But that's a big deal, and that can contribute to muscle imbalances, not feeling comfortable with your form. And but it perhaps might not be enough of a nuisance for you to pick up on it. So you'll start compensating. And if one hand is closer than another, then the weight on that side is going to be heavier. So you may start compensating by having more weight on your left foot and all these things. So set your feet, be intentional about your grip on the bar. And then in this instance with the barbell row, we're driving our elbows up and back. Let me backtrack. Before we drive our elbows up and back, we are going to retract our scapula, which is pulling our shoulder blades back. And we are going to in the row, instance of using a barbell row. Chest up, of course, it is technically facing down, but we want to think chest up, shoulders back, and we want to, with that firm base on the ground, kind of solidify ourselves in place. In an ideal world, with the in a utopia of perfect form, really the only thing that's moving is our arms. We're hinging at the elbow, we're driving those movements as high as they can go into the air, up and back, and we're just kind of continuing that way. Being a 5'9 homie right here, I believe Hayden's probably 6 feet, maybe even a little taller. Ed's maybe 5'11 or something. I'll have them in one of these upcoming videos, they can talk. But it's posed a little more of a challenge for them with their leverages, having longer legs. And we're gonna work on this. We're gonna have the load, the weight lighter, so we can work on that form, something that feels comfortable for them. And if ultimately it's a movement that they can't engage with and feel their lats engaging, their upper back engaging, then we can substitute it. And that's the beauty of weight training, is for every exercise, there's, I don't know, probably 200 alternates. I just made that up, number up completely, but there's dozens of alternates we can do. We can use machines, we can use dumbbells. If you've been conservative with the weight and you don't really connect with the movement over a period of time, after you've given it a valiant effort, then you can kind of ditch it if you're not really feeling it or feeling that that contraction. Okay, I've been talking a lot, man. This clip is probably super long. The Celsius smells like rotisserie chicken. No one knows what that means.
Do you care to explain? Because
I put
go ahead.
Want an endorsement.
Go ahead.
I put my Celsius cans from the
grocery
store.
Don't you dare put their branding on there either.
In the same bag. Same bag as a rotisserie chicken, and I got chicken juice grease all over my Celsiuses.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And, I get a nice waft of rotisserie chicken every time I put it. Chest and back. For the lats, we want to keep those elbows close, get a full extension and a stretch on those lats together. And then, as we come up, we want to pull that rope apart. Ideally, we get that rope as far down, like we're like driving it into our, right above our you-know-what. Because as our elbows travel behind our shoulder, we'll target that rear delt. So, of course, you can also do a straight-arm pushdown with the rope. Maybe a tad easier to target the rear delts, but this is a cool alternate. I like doing it. Traction, slow on the eccentric portion, on the negative. That's a workout in itself, too.
Oh yeah, making sure you're not being an idiot like I was on the last couple sets. Quick question for you. At what point in your workout process is it okay to wear tanks? They need to be how big?
10% lower than Brian, so I'm gonna say like...
So you're 15
like... 15 inches circular.
Okay.
80% capacity.
Yeah.
We're looking at like 14 inches minimum.
So you're there what, next week?
I'm at like 5 inches.
Okay, cool.
So I need to grow 10 more inches before I can start wearing tanks.
Okay, I got it.
But after I get the implants of my upper chest,
yeah,
then I can probably...
I hear you.
Because if your ratio of your upper chest...
So I may end up referencing my last video a couple times in this, but I think I like laid some groundwork, seeing that I haven't been but on YouTube much. God, I need to learn how to use words again. For like 6 months. And I'm training with a couple buddies in the gym, a guy named Hayden, a guy named Ed. They're two awesome human beings, super dope, and just good friends. And we are going through the program together. They're kind of like my clients if I was training people in the gym, but they're not. They're just buddies who want to go through this training program with me, and I'm helping them a lot with various different things in this wonderful land of get yoked and lose fat. The right way to do things, in my opinion, is not always the most obvious, and we can get sidetracked a lot. And I'm gonna call one out right now just because it's on the top of my head, and also because it's fun to do this, and he'll probably bring it up to me later if he watches this video, which I think he will. What's going on, Hayden? Hayden, guys, Hayden thinks about biohacking too much, and he kind of, Yes, I'm going there. Hate it. Overthinking about I need to drink this certain type of water. I can't drink this distilled water. I need to have ashwagandha at 9:07 a.m. in the morning. And it's like, holy, like I'm getting so much anxiety just hearing all these considerations of what it will take to gain muscle, lose fat, shift your body composition. And I'm kind of like hyping this up a little bit. Hayden is a very intelligent individual. He was a professional soccer player at one point, not anymore. But he does a lot of these things for health. So, but I'm alluding to a bigger, I think, fallacy or just misguided avenue. Several misguided avenues we like to take when it comes to losing fat and gaining muscle, which is focusing on the wrong things. And the things that are most important, and I'll harp on these till the day I die, is controlling your caloric intake and your macronutrients, proteins, carbs, fats, because energy intake is king, and making sure your macronutrient ratio intake makes sense for your current goals. Those are the factors that are going to push the dial forward for us the most. One last caveat I'll add, because I'm kind of rambling right now, which I love to do, is, and Hayden loved when I told him this at one point, I'm a trainer. I never, and punch me in the face if I ever have said this, I don't think I have, I'm not in the business of like making you a healthier person. My job, the way I see it, is to support you in reducing your body fat percentage and increasing your muscle mass. Now, of course, that's going to come with becoming a healthier human being for the vast majority of people. But I'm not a nutritionist, I'm not a dietitian, and I'm not here to front and act like I can support you with the deep science and the biohacking specifics of things. I'm here to get fat off your body and increase your muscle mass and have you feeling phenomenal in the process. And I've learned a thing or two on proper things to eat and things that we consume often that probably do not serve us. But those are two different aims, in my opinion, is dieting specifically for health and then for shifting your body composition. And of course there's crossovers and things like this. Quick example with body composition is competition prep is not healthy. Getting down to a super low body fat percentage for a human body is not a healthy thing, and it's not recommended to do super often. But that being said, don't write off competing completely. I think there's a huge return when it comes to the discipline that you formulate and what you learn about yourself and pushing yourself to the limit throughout that process. It makes it well worth it. But technically, like on paper, hand to God, if he exists up there, definitely does. I had to add that for my mom. I think I'm gonna leave that in the video. Yeah. Technically on paper, dieting is not super healthy when you're getting down to very low body fat percentages, but the truth is, 90% of the time, being a bodybuilder or being someone, even if you're not a bodybuilder or into this competition environment at all, being a person who is very passionate about weight training and reducing your body fat percentage and gaining muscle is a very healthy thing to do, and I encourage anyone to do it. Yeah, let me know if you guys like this style of video. And that's all she wrote. I have that feeling, you know that feeling where it's like you feel like you're forgetting something but you can't really think of it? I kind of have that right now. And yeah, it's like when you get home from the grocery store, it's like, I didn't buy toilet paper. God. So I'll probably realize after this video, but either way, have a great day. I'll probably be back in a couple days. If you like this rawness, then like the video, please. Please like the video and share it with a friend. Send it to a friend and be like, hey, this guy makes videos. Just say that. All right? Love you. See you in the next video. Peace. I got my 40 ounce.